Hello and welcome back to my channel. Today we'll be looking at this beautiful box that I 3D printed that has no seals or gaskets and it still manages to be waterproof. While searching for ideas to 3D print, I came across a wonderful video from Slant3D where they 3D print a watertight enclosure that protects outside electronics from water without the use of a seal. Now, the idea of preventing water from getting into spaces through water management alone by blocking its path with something is not new, but the use of FDM technology opens up new possibilities that would be impossible or very, very expensive for injection molding, like adding a lip here. Anyway, this kind of design is perfectly fine and is proven to be very, very effective. The idea behind it is that you have a rectangular box with four drainage holes, and instead of a seal, you have a channel that collects all the water and drains it towards the sides and bottom hole. And as long as the channel doesn't overflow, water cannot physically get into the enclosure. But I was determined to over-engineer it. Remember when I mentioned overflowing? I believe that there is a possibility that the drainage holes could be used as entry points for water and cause the channel to overflow. This wouldn't happen under normal circumstances, but I was determined to abuse the hell out of this box by the end of the video. Stick around and find out. I then started doing some rough concept sketches of the drainage section and thought about keeping the original concept of a channel going around the box where the water can drain, but changing the drainage hole so that it lets as little water in as possible. My idea was having a channel like this, where water just drains away from the section, but also allows for drainage when it sits inverted at the bottom. My head started to hurt while thinking about this, so I started modeling it in Catia. First, we begin with the profile. I drew a sketch and create output profiles of the two sections. Then I outline the box shape and sweep the profiles along the curve. After we check that everything works, we can create bodies for the box and lid so that we can separate them. After I create a rib feature using the profiles, I then create the bottom of the box, making sure it's parametric so I can easily change it afterwards. Now comes the interesting part. I sketch my first draft of the drainage channel. Like the profile, I draw it in the origin and plan to move it to the desired location with the axis to axis command. Since it's difficult to shape inside the part, I model it as a solid and plan to remove it afterwards with a Boolean operation. To allow for drainage, the lid has to be cut as well, but I don't like that if I cut it, it'll allow water directly into the section, and I think about reducing the thickness locally instead. Considering this will be mounted vertically, most likely, it needs a slope to better drain. So instead of having the box shaped like a rectangle, I try to angle the channel towards the middle to create a slope. I begin to think about the attachments. I don't want to increase the size by extending it outward, and I don't want to cut holes in the bottom of the box for water tightness reasons. So I model these four tabs with keyhole slots. The idea is that the screws will be already on the wall and we just slot this box into them. Coming back to the drainage channel, I was concerned that there is not enough section in the drainage hole to drain that big channel that we had. So I decided to add two drainage slots instead of one. Finally, I designed some basic clips to hold the lid into place, since I didn't want to compromise the water tightness using screws. I was a bit concerned about the tolerances for the lid and how it would fit into the box, so I cut a small section and decided to 3D print that because it was faster. I didn't want to waste time and material and I wanted it done as fast as possible, so I optimized it a little bit. Decided to print this in PLA because that was already on my printer, I was too lazy to switch it, and it only took an hour and a half. After I 3D print a test section of the profile, I noticed that there is in fact a straight line of sight where a water jet could spray water directly into the drainage channel, and I didn't want that, so I decided to increase the height of the lid locally, just a little bit to hide this. So now my section would look something like this, which is a huge improvement to what I had earlier, and it's honestly quite surprising I didn't thought of it in the first place. I export everything to Cura. I have to print this in PETG as PLA is pretty bad for sitting outside in the sun. It has low UV resistance and it kind of absorbs water as well. A better choice would be ASA, but I don't have that available right now. I'd like to take this time to remind you to please subscribe to my channel if you enjoyed watching these type of videos. It really means a lot to me. Unfortunately, two of my clips broke off while printing the lid, but I think this should work for now. Otherwise, I'm pretty happy with the quality of this. Maybe a little upset that I cannot actually get a print off my bed without ripping off the painter's tape I have on my bed. The actual box takes a lot longer, it's 14 hours, but I'm really happy of how it turned out. I pry it out from the bed because it's really, really sticky. The whole printing process takes about 23 hours, not including setup time, so it's a bit long for me, but in the end it'll be worth it. Now we are ready to test it and see if it actually holds up. I begin by screwing it in, like we talked about earlier, and plan to use a garden hose to spray water on the box. I will be sticking a bit of tissue inside before each test to be able to check if it's wet or not. Before we begin, we need to talk about what watertight actually means. This is usually defined through IP rating, which stands for ingress protection. This is a standardized system for components through which it is defined to what degree the product is watertight. For example, you may have heard of IP44 or IP55, but what does that actually mean? The first number from the IP rating refers to the dust or solid mass protection, and the second one refers to the water protection, and they are specified in this chart. For example, our pot does not have a seal, but it is a closed section, so it'll have at least a 4 on the dust protection scale, as it will not allow solid bodies larger than 1 mm into the enclosure. As for the water protection, without a seal, we will never be able to submerge it, so we can never achieve a 7 on this scale, so what's left to do is to test it and see how far we can go. First test, I'll do with low pressure to simulate rain. We'll spray it really well with water from all angles to make sure we get a IP44 rating at least. And we make sure to wipe it with a rag to not contaminate the tissue. And we check the result. Perfectly dry, so now we have a starting point for our IP rating. Second test is with high pressure garden hose settings, while keeping some distance from the box. After thoroughly spraying it, we wipe it really well. And check the tissue, and it's dry again. Third test is using the high pressure setting, but trying to spray the back of the box, targeting the drainage holes from all sides and the seam between the lid and the body. This is the weak point and should be the worst case scenario. And believe it or not, it's dry again. Perfect score so far. Now it's time to bring out the big guns. I pull out my trusty pressure washer, load up the tissue, and start blasting. If it manages to pass this test, that means it gets a 6K rating on the water tightness scale, which is the highest it could achieve without submerging it in water. After wiping it and checking the tissue, I see that it's perfectly dry again. So, perfect score, IP46 rating, but am I satisfied with that? Absolutely not. I want to push it to its limits to see where it actually fails. So for my next test, I plan to simulate it with the lid improperly placed. I try to position the lid so that the drainage hole at the top is visible and it's not actually covered. And I begin my first test with a low pressure setting on the hose to simulate light rain. After I spray it really well, I check the result. And surprisingly so, this looks pretty dry, which makes me really happy. For my next test, I'll be using the high pressure garden hose setting, and I will be targeting the drainage holes, trying to overflow the channel that goes around the lid. Watch this footage closely and see how the water that is sprayed with high pressure directly into the hole evacuates through the back of the box instead of going into the channel. This is exactly what I've designed the channel to do. And I'm really happy to see this. Even though it should be covered and will not actually do this in real life, or if the lid is properly placed, this is really nice to see. After I'm satisfied I abused this box enough, I wipe it really well and open up the box to see what happens. And as you can see in this footage, it looks like water has gone through. So if you improperly place the lid and spray it with a high pressure garden hose, then it will fail. So that wraps it up for this video. Let me know what you think. Would you trust this box for your high value electronics to sit outside in the rain and possibly garden sprinkles? Or would you prefer an off the shelf box with a seal? Let me know what you think in the comment section, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel, leave a like, and see you next time.